एवरीवन वेलकम टू ऑरियन एकेडमी। ऑरियन एकेडमी में आप सभी का स्वागत है। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस वन ऑफ द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक ऑफ मॉडर्न हिस्ट्री, दैट इज सैनिक कमीशन। सो यू कैन आस्क मी सर, व्हाई आर यू स्टार्टिंग विद सैनिक कमीशन, और व्हाई आर यू गोइंग टू टीच सैनिक कमीशन सडनली? द थिंग इज दैट वी हैव टेकन अ डिसीजन फ्रॉम नाउ ऑनवर्ड्स, वी विल मेक सम इंपॉर्टेंट और कंसेप्चुअल वीडियोस ऑन डिफरेंट सब्जेक्ट्स लाइक हिस्ट्री, लाइक ज्योग्राफी, लाइक साइंस, लाइक इकोनॉमी, लाइक पॉलिटी। सो दिस इज ए पार्ट ऑफ दैट प्रोग्राम। So what we are going to do, we are going to discuss on Simon Commission. This is a concept video. Here, what are the things, what are the different issues related to Simon Commission we are going to discuss. The first important thing we are going to discuss, what was Simon Commission, what was it? That's the first thing. What was it? What was Simon Commission? Why did it form? Kyun Simon Commission bana tha? Why did it form? That's the second question we are going to discuss. Third, what was the reaction of the Indians against the Simon Commission? What was the reaction of Indians? What was the reactions? Okay, of Indians. Reaction of Indians. And finally, the consequence. Finally, the consequence. These are the various issues we are going to discuss specially with respect to this particular topic, Simon Commission. So let's start. So before starting Simon Commission, let's see the background. Okay. So whenever you will start any topic, or you will just try to understand any topic, you have to understand the background. What was happening? Okay, what are the consequences of that particular incident, and why did Simon Commission form suddenly? The first important thing, let us go to the 1919 Government of India Act. Okay, so Government of India Act, which is also popularly known as Montagu-James Code Act, that was implemented in 1919. Okay, so Government of India Act. Government of India that was implemented in 1919. What was the speciality about this Government of India Act 1919? That is very important, that we have to understand. See, in case of the Government of India Act 1919, there were two important provisions. There were different provisions, but here I will discuss for this, for understanding Simon Commission, there were two important provisions which are very important to understand before understanding Simon Commission. Clear? The first important thing was, through this Government of India Act 1919, or the Montagu-James Code Act 1919, this diarchy system was implemented in the provinces. Okay, not in the center. Diarchy system was implemented in the provinces. And the next important provision of the Simon Commission was separate electorate. Not Simon, sorry. Montagu-James Code Act or Government of India Act 1919 was separate electorate. See, separate electorate was already introduced through 1909 Molyminto Act. Clear? 1909 Molyminto Act, where separate electorate was introduced for the Muslims. Here through 1990 Government of India Act or Montagu-James Code Act, this separate electorate was extended for the Sikhs, for the Anglo-Indian community, for the Christian community. Now let's try to understand what was diarchy very briefly, because diarchy is not, or Government of India Act is not our today's topic. Our today's topic is Simon Commission. So let's try to understand very briefly what was diarchy system. Let me erase it first. Just let me explain you the diarchy system very briefly. See, the diarchy system was implemented through this Government of India Act or Montagu-James Code Act in the provinces. Now in the provinces, there was a list of the matters or subjects on which these provincial legislatures used to make laws. And subject matters on which the state or provinces will make laws. These subjects were divided into two categories. On which these provinces will make laws, those subjects were divided into two categories. One was reserved category. Are you getting my point? One was reserved and the other was transferred category. Transferred category. Okay. So this reserve category, under this reserve category, there were very important topics or very important subjects like law and order, finance, land and revenue, etc. These were under the reserve subjects. And who, this reserve subject was under the control of the governor, who was the head of the province, and his executive council. Clear? And his executive council. I think you have understood that the under the diarchy system, the matters or the subjects on which the provinces will make laws, those subjects were divided into two categories. One is reserve subject. Under the reserve subject, there were some important topics, the most important topics like law and order, finance and land revenue, etc. This was completely given under the control of the governor and his executive council. And this transfer subject was under the ministers of the provinces. There, the subjects like health, education, okay, etc., these were under this transfer subject. Basically, this health and education was less important for the British. Especially, this is about Indian education. So, British has nothing to do with it. So, these were very less important to the British. That is why they transferred it to the transfer subject. Okay. So, this transfer subject was under the control of the ministers of the provinces. Okay. These were under the control of the ministers of the provinces. Now, let's try to understand. Who were the ministers? Ministers were, that means elected or nominated ministers. These persons were elected by whom? These persons were elected by a very limited number of electors. Okay, who were the electors at that time? Let me tell you, the person or the people who had certain degree of education and who had certain amount of money. So money and education were the two important criteria to become an elector. Okay, so you can understand at that time during this 1920s, so basically, very limited people, they were electors. Okay. So now this elected ministers, they were responsible to the legislature. But this governor and executive council, they were not responsible to the legislature. So the most important topics under the control of the governor and his executive council, who was not responsible to the legislature. And less important topic, less important in the sense I am telling you that in the eyes of the Britishers, the less important topics like health and education, these were given under the control of the ministers, okay, and who were responsible to the legislatures. Now, let's see, this was basically an eyewash. Why I am saying that? Because finance was under the control of the governor. Suppose these ministers are trying to make some new laws on health or new hospital, so they will require finance, but this finance was under the control of the governor and who was not responsible to the legislature, who used to take decision arbitrarily, okay. So, you can understand. If the ministers also initiate some good scheme or some welfare scheme, in that case, finance will not be sanctioned from the side of the governor. So that's how this diarchy was just an eyewash. So Indians, nationalist leader at that time, they opposed strongly against this diarchy system. Okay, all the Indian nationalist leaders at that time and the people who understood politics at that particular time, even the government of India, they completely opposed this diarchy system. Okay, so there was strong opposition from Indian side against this diarchy, and the other was separate electorate. You know, the Indian National Congress never supported the separate electorate. You cannot support separate electorate, okay? Through the separate electorate, what Britishers were trying to do, government was trying to do, they were trying to divide our countries in different factions. Separate electorate for Sikhs, separate electorate for Christians, separate electorate for the Muslims. So you can understand they are trying to, you know, divide the country in different factions. Into different factions. Okay, so these were two provisions which Indians they strongly opposed this particular provisions of the government of India. So they were advocating in favor of the changes or the constitutional reforms of the government of India Act 1990. Now, all you have heard about the Swaraj Party. When the Swaraj Party was formed, 1923, just immediately after the withdrawal of the non-cooperation movement in 1922. Okay, so all you know that this non-cooperation movement was withdrawn in 1922 after the event of Chauri Chaura. And this the Swaraj Party was formed. And what was the main objective of the Swaraj Party? To take entry into the legislature and to rake the government from within. Okay, wahan pe jaake, they will oppose the government whenever government will come with some new repressive or oppressive laws. So, the Swaraj Party took entry into the legislature and they started advocating in favor of the change of the Government of India Act 1919, that means Montagu James Ford Act 1919. And there was another important provision under this Government of India Act 1919, that provision was that after 10 years, a Royal Commission will be formed, that Royal Commission will look into the success of the Government of India Act or the relevance of the Government of India Act after 10 years, that means in the year 1929. Royal Commission, and they will look into the constitutional reforms of India by changing if they think that if they want to change the Government of India Act 1919, they will change it and they will suggest the required reform, constitutional reforms for it. Now, when the Swaraj Party, they took entry into the legislature, they started advocating strongly against this Government of India Act 1919, and they started advocating in favor of the immediate formation of the Royal Commission to look into the matter of the constitutional reforms of India. Clear? So, ye to ho raha tha, chal raha tha us time pe. And there was another issue, election in Britain in 1928. So, at that time, Conservative Party was in power in Britain and Labour Party was in opposition. So, Conservative Party was apprehended that they might lose the election. Okay, so before the election, each and every government does, you know, that they also tried to, at that time, this Conservative Party also tried to make themselves or prove themselves very responsible government, especially with respect to their colonial matters as well. So, prior to 1929, when, it was prefixed that in the 1929, a Royal Commission will form and that commission will look into the success and failure of the Government of India Act 1919 and they will suggest required measures. But just 1 year before this 1929, this election year in 1928, this Conservative government, they instructed the Secretary of State, Lord Birkenhead, at that time Lord Birkenhead was Secretary of State, to form a commission to look into the constitutional reforms of India. Okay. Now, Mr. Lord Birkenhead formed a commission of 7 members. What was the objective of the formation of this commission? You have already understood. They will look into the matter of the constitutional reforms of India. Government of India Act 1999. All of you have heard about, all of you. Just I have already discussed the Government of India Act 1919. What are the successes and failures and loopholes of the Government of India Act? They will investigate it and they will suggest required measures, okay, in accordance with that. Okay. So that is the reason why this commission was formed. This commission was headed by Mr. John Simon, this gentleman. You can see here, this gentleman. Sir John Simon. He was the chairman of the commission and the name of the commission was after his name. That was the reason why the name of the commission was Simon Commission. And another important member of this commission was Clement Attlee. At that time, he didn't know he was so important because he later became the Prime Minister of Britain. That was why this name is very important. Clement Attlee was also the member of the Simon Commission. Okay. Now, here, this commission consisted of 7 members, I have already told you. And the ridiculous thing about the commission, that all the members, they were Englishmen. Okay, all the members of the commission were Englishmen. Why I am saying it was ridiculous? Because these people are coming to look for the Indian constitutional reforms, excluding Indians. Okay, so the commission consisted of no Indian member and they are coming here without understanding our sentiment, our customs, our traditions. They are coming here and they are trying to make laws for the Indians, excluding Indians. Okay, so the commission didn't have a single Indian member. So, Indian different political parties at that time in India, especially like Hindu Mahasabha, like Indian National Congress, like Muslim League, they started taking decision that what should be their position with respect to this commission. So there was an annual session of Indian National Congress in Madras in December 1927 and they took the decision to boycott this commission at every stage and every form. What was the stand of other political parties? First, let's see the Muslim League, the position of Muslim League. Now, Muslim League was divided into 2 different parts, especially with respect to this particular issue. The old and orthodox section of the Muslim League, they started advocating in favor of the government and in favor of the Simon Commission. They told them, no, isko chhod do, actually. We shouldn't protest against Simon Commission. And one section of the Muslim League, headed by Mr. Muhammad Ali Jinnah and his young followers, they started opposing the Simon Commission. And they tried to convince Muhammad Ali Jinnah especially tried to convince this old section and orthodox section of the Muslim League that we should start all-round protest against Simon Commission. They have completely excluded the Indians from their commission and they are coming here to make laws. So that's not justified. They will once again make a galop law. Okay, wrong constitutional reforms. They will once again do some wrong constitutional reforms. So we should start all-round protest against this commission. Okay, that was the, opinion of Muhammad Ali Jinnah. And when there was no such kind of reconciliation between this 2 group of Muslim League, Muhammad Ali Jinnah separately with his young followers started protesting against Simon Commission. What was the stunt of Hindu Mahasabha? The stunt of Hindu Mahasabha was also very clear. They also took the decision to oppose Simon Commission. Another political party, let me tell you here, Justice Party. Justice Party was formed in Madras, all you know, this is anti-Brahmin party, Justice Party. I will later discuss about Justice Party definitely. So Justice Party, they took the decision to support Simon Commission. Okay, these were different stance of the different political parties at that time in India. Now finally, what happened? So Congress has taken the decision, and Muslim League has taken the decision, Hindu Mahasabha has taken the decision. So basically, the Indian response, the position of the Indians, especially with respect to Simon Commission, dekhiye, yahan pe, Simon Commission was very much welcome. The Commission was very much welcome, because Indians were also wanting or demanding constitutional reforms. So the Britishers, they have formed a committee or a commission for the constitutional reforms of India. That is very welcome. They are very much welcome. But the problem with the commission was there was not a single Indian in the commission. So how can you make laws for a country without the Indian members? Okay, you do not know the sentiment, you do not know the customs, tradition, nothing else. Okay, the ancient or the past of our countries, past tradition of our countries. So that was the only position, that was the only, complaint of the Indians against this particular commission. So Indians were outraged at their exclusions from the commission. Okay, now let's try to understand next important issue, that when this commission landed, where did they land? In Bombay. Us time pe ship mein aate the ye. So this commission came from Britain and they landed in Bombay on February 3rd, 1928. And there was all round protest against this commission. So all these political parties, you have already seen political parties like Muslim, already in Indian National Congress has taken the decision to boycott this commission at every stage. Okay. And Muslim League led by Muhammad Ali Jinnah, they have also taken the decision to oppose this Simon Commission. Hindu Mahasabha also has taken the decision to oppose this commission. So there was when this commission landed in Bombay, they couldn't understand before even just before landing, they couldn't understand what were waiting for them. So basically there was countrywide hartal, mass rallies, and there was lot of demonstration. When this commission landed in Bombay, there was lot of demonstration against this commission with black flags. Okay, go back Simon, go back. You were coming here to make laws for Indians, excluding Indians. So you just go back. Okay, so that was the demonstration that was going on all over the countries. These things were going on all over the countries. There were a lot of procession, lot of mass rallies, lot of demonstration against Simon Commission. And with that slogan, go back Simon, go back Simon, go back Simon. Okay, that was what happening all over the country. Okay, once again, it seems to be the country was arrogant. Okay, against this particular commission. Okay. Now, what was the reaction of the government? What was the reaction of the police? So, government was not, you can understand government to, mithai nahi khilayega, hai na? So, basically, when there was a lot of demonstration against the Simon Commission, government was outraged and they started and they actually sent police to suppress this kind of mass rallies, this kind of demonstration. And police started lathi charge. That's the only activity of the police, you know, and, firing and lathi charge. So police was doing the same thing. Okay, so police started lathi charging. Even they didn't spare the senior and respectful leaders of the of our country. Like Pandit Nehru was also not spared. And the respectful and senior leader like Lala Lajpat Rai, when he was demonstrating against this commission in Lahore, he was brutally lathi charged by the police and later he died in the hospital. And all over the country there were all round protests against the Simon Commission, against this particular brutality, against the death of Lala Lajpat Rai. So when these things were happening, this gentleman, Lord Birkenhead, I have already told you the name of Lord Birkenhead. Who was this person? He formed the Simon Commission. He was the Secretary of State. So this person, Lord Birkenhead. So what did he say? So you Indians, he was saying, this Lord Birkenhead, he was saying that you Indians, you are protesting against Simon Commission. We have formed Simon Commission for your constitutional reforms. Aapke bhalai ke liye banaya gaya hai ye. So we have formed Simon Commission for the constitutional reforms of India. And you were protesting against the Simon Commission. You Indians, you have different political parties here. Okay, like Muslim League, they have different interests. Congress, they have different interests. Justice Party, they have different interests. Hindu Mahasabha, they have different interests. V.R. Ambedkar, he has different interests. So, with general agreement or with consensus, will you Indian be able to draft a future constitution of India? I can challenge you. This Birkenhead is saying, I can challenge you that you Indians will not be able to draft the future constitution of India with consensus, with general agreement among all the parties. So that was the challenge of Birkenhead. So just listening this challenge, all the political parties, they listened it, and finally a all-party conference that was convened in the same month, February 1928. Are challenge kya hai Birkenhead ne? Okay, so there was a all-party conference in the month of February 1928. And this all-party conference, this political parties of Indians, and basically the Indians, they accepted the challenge of Mr. Birkenhead. And they took the decision, yes, we would draft the future constitution for India. And okay, let's do it. And basically Motilal Nehru was given the responsibility by this all-party conference. Motilal Nehru was given the responsibility to draft a constitution for future constitution for India. A committee was formed. The members from or representative from all the political parties were there in the committee. And this committee was headed by Motilal Nehru, that is called as also Motilal Nehru Committee. And the report which was given by Motilal Nehru Committee is popularly known as Nehru Report. Who are the other members of the committee? Tej Bahadur Shapru, Subhash Chandra Bose, M.S. Anay, Mangal Singh, Ali Imam, Sok Qureshi and J.R. Prodhan. These were the other members of the committee. So what was the objective behind the formation of the Nehru Committee? To draft the future constitution of India. Okay. By accepting the challenge of Birkenhead. Parallelly with Simon Commission, they would also draft the future constitution of India. So okay, let's see. But the problem, the challenge of the Birkenhead was that you Indians would not be able to do it with general agreement. Okay, that was the challenge of Birkenhead. In the next class, we will see whether Indians were able to, you know, reply the challenge of Birkenhead, okay, or not. So here today we will end it here. So I think you have understood the issues related to Simon Commission, and in the next class also we will see the recommendations of Simon Commission and recommendation of Nehru Report. So for today I'm ending this class here. Okay, if you like this video, you can share, you can subscribe, you can comment if you have any question. After that, thank you very much. Best of luck for all of you.